everyone. Meteorologist Adrian Castellano here in Montgomery. The Hurricane Hunters tour ongoing here at the airport. And here's one of the Hurricane Hunter planes. This is actually the same plane that would fly into hurricanes as they approach the Gulf Coast or really anywhere across the Atlantic Basin. So I'm going to show you a little bit of what you can expect to see on these planes. Pretty cool, all the equipment that they have on the actual plane itself.
You can get a little coordinate where you are, to know where you are, where you're going. Now you can just look down and
just a little better view of what we have on this plane itself. You know, we have two basic workstations where the meteorologists will sit, and they can see radar and all kinds of other meteorological data. So pretty cool setup here. This is actually called a drop sign, and it goes in this right here. It actually shoots out of the plane. Eventually, it gets down to the ocean surface. That's going to measure winds. It's going to measure the temperature, moisture content, everything that the hurricane feeds off of. So that basically shows you exactly how the atmosphere is comprised weather-wise from the plane on down. Now, here's another one of the workstations right here where a meteorologist will sit while the plane is actually flying. You see a lot going on here. You have the view outside the plane, and actually back up above here, you take a couple steps and there's the area where the pilots are stationed. So here's one of the meteorologists right here.
Hello.
This is my Facebook Live.
Okay.
So we were actually talking a little while ago about, you know, all the meteorological data that comes in and how all that gets fed into the plane, how you guys, you know, you gather that, it gets sent back to the Hurricane Center, and all that actually ends up being looked at and used to come up with the forecast themselves, the track forecast, the intensity forecast, as a hurricane threatens the Gulf Coast, really anywhere. So just go through really quickly the stuff that you look at when you're on board here.
Sure. So at my workstation, I've got a couple different screens I'm looking at. The primary one is what we call the ARWO computer, the Aerial Reconnaissance Weather Officer computer. And on that, I'm getting all of the data that's from the sensors that the aircraft is collecting. I'm also looking at data that comes from the drop sondes that we're releasing to get a vertical profile of the atmosphere. So I'm looking at those, I'm communicating those out to the National Hurricane Center, and at the same time, I'm also chatting with them in a text messenger type program to be able to tell them qualitatively what's happening, and then they give me feedback as well as what they're seeing in the bigger picture. So we kind of work together to make that happen.
That's where your radar would be.
Correct. Yep.
Minute by minute, you're looking at that to figure out exactly where you need to fly, because you need to fly into the center of the storm.
Correct. Yep.
Eventually, you know, you check out every single quadrant of the storm, every quadrant of the hurricane, developing system, but it's important to get into the center of a hurricane to see exactly how the structure is evolving in the actual position as the hurricane moves along.
Yeah, you can't measure the worst weather if you're not in it.
Exactly. So an amazing job y'all do, and I don't know if a lot of people would be willing to do something like that. it'd be a little intimidating, even for me.
Oh, sure.
Well, thank you so much for giving us a little tour. Yeah. So once again, this is the Hurricane Hunter plane. Here's a look where the pilots would be stationed flying the aircraft through the hurricane. Once again, something that I probably would not want to do. So